Willy Wonder bonus map. Or you can replay the crash course again. Or you can quit and feel my wrath. I am not even kidding. You will feel my wrath. Wrath. I wasn't kidding about the wrath. Oh,
this is 1187, a horror-themed Half-Life 2 mod developed by Team GT.
I know about this place. I saw it on the news one time.
The description on the ModDB page reads, almost a decade after the Black Mesa incident, which opened up the portal storms, you find yourself trying to cope with its aftermath. Creatures appeared, which came out of what seemed to be thin air. They came without warning and swept the world. It is during this time you find yourself in your apartment, alone, for no apparent reason. You've been approached, as in a dream, by a man in a suit. Having no idea of what's going on, all you can try to do is stay alive. This is a single-player Half-Life 2 modification, which takes place sometime after the 7-Hour War, which its newest release, version 1.30, was released November 17th, 2010.
All these messages, to me, it represents hope.
Now, there's a lot of things I like about this mod, there's a lot of things I don't like, and there's some things I completely hate. For example, early on, I died a lot. Like, every time I tried to get past the first enemy, I died a lot. I turned the difficulty down, and I still died, not as much, but I still died a lot.
Gameplay will vary a little from the standard.
One of the first things I noticed when I started playing this mod is how good the textures looked. They just look good. I don't know what they changed with them, but I like it. Some of the cool features about this game is iron sights, view bobbling, vision swaying, sprint blurring, and there's melee attacks for every weapon.
Just grab both the shotgun and the Beretta.
As cool as some of those features are, the vision bobbling and then the movement swaying really threw me off. What's really nice about that, though, is there's options to turn that off within the game. So, when I started playing this mod, you know, it seemed kind of cool. But as I got further and further into it, I couldn't get hooked on the story. The game got repetitive. And it just wasn't appealing to me.
The soldiers are definitely after us. I don't know why, but it just seems to be the way it is.
Some of the things I didn't like about this mod is the dude you chill with, whatever his name is, gets in your way a lot, and he takes forever to move out of it. And he says, "Let me get out of your way," all the time. It's like, okay, I know you're in my way, but just get the fuck out and shut up. It's really easy to kind of lose track of where you're going and where you have been and stuff like that, unless you, you know, memorize the maps and stuff like that. And there's no map, so I know there isn't in just regular Half-Life, but they could do it. It's not that hard. Along with that, it's kind of easy to forget what you're supposed to be doing at the moment, so I think they should implement some kind of objectives thing. They could easily do that by hitting tab or something like that. It's been done by several other games. It'd be perfect in this game. One of the best things about this mod has to be the voice acting. There's just so much of it, but done by the dude that comes with you and people you meet along the way. All of it's good. I really liked it. Along with the voice acting, they did good animating to like go with it. They did a really good job on that. Something I liked, and kind of hated at the same time, is they have only three or four weapons that can use the flashlight. I think it's the pistol, the shotgun, and the MP5, and that's it. That's all that has the flashlight. Anything else, you can't use the flashlight with. Now, that's not a bad thing, because that's very practical, but say I run out of ammo with every other weapon, and all I have is, say, you know, like the sniper rifle or something like that. You know, I'll be shooting in the dark and I'll even waste more ammo. It's kind of stupid. So, they could have just gave every weapon a flashlight. Or they could have done it like the suit does. And just have the battery life. That's a very small, trivial thing. And, overall, it's not a bad idea. But it's not foolproof. Some quick statistics about the mod. There's been 2,225 downloads. There's 1,333 watchers currently. Its rank is 66 out of 13,021. And there's been 169,062 page views.
That's when I took up the project. I've been funding it on my own ever since. Well, I've probably bored you to death, so I'll open the door now.
Someone wanted to score major brownie points with me. They should take the Iron Sights out of this game and put it in just Half-Life 2. That'd be awesome. My only issue with the Iron Sights is why is the pistol and the revolver so close to the face? In real life, wouldn't you hold your arms straight out? It seems practical what they have for the rifles, but not the pistol and the revolver. And also, with the rifles in a first-person shooter, I don't think you really want peep sights. It seems just too difficult to aim when you can't see what's on top of your sights.
I understand, man. Thanks for everything.
To me, this is one of those games that you really want to keep an eye on, because there's a lot of stuff they can improve on, and once they improve on that stuff, it'll become a great mod. Once again, this is the 1187 mod for Half-Life 2. Download it, check it out. Hope you enjoyed my review.
Never watch a day in his life.
And mama, some bad talk going around town saying that papa had three outside children and another wife. And that ain't right.
Heard some talk about papa doing some storefront preaching.
talking about saving souls and all the time leeching. Dealing in debt and stealing in the name of the Lord. Mama just hold my head and say, Papa was a holy son.
Mama looked up with a tear in her eye and said, son,
Papa was a lonely soul.